First Peter chapter 1 verse 3. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Are you there?
Amen.
First Peter chapter 1 verse 3. Say the word of God. Say, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again. Remember? Because we're born in this world from our mothers, but then we're born dead and sin, but he begotten us again. That means we're born again. Remember? A new birth. Amen?
Yes.
Again to a living hope. Remember, living hope. Amen? We're going to call it today godly hope. A difference than the hope that people have. Right? You know, there's a godly hope. Yes. To a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. To an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled and that does not fade away. Amen?
Amen.
Reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Just you see, we have a hope. And this is a godly hope, okay? That all these things that's written is going to be so.
Amen.
And this is our hope, that we are inheritors, okay? We have faith, that's true, but our hope is the one to make us to believe this coming. It doesn't matter what's going on around us. It doesn't matter what we see, but we have that hope. Whatever God said is true, it's going to come to pass.
Come on.
Amen. That's our hope. Amen. That's what we're going to call it, godly hope. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And the faith in Christ makes possible a living hope. That faith in Christ made possible this living hope of godly hope. Okay? Because we believe everything Christ says is true.
Amen.
Amen. That our faith in Christ, Jesus, made possible a living hope. Okay? Amen. Hallelujah. And remember, this hope is a godly hope. Okay?
Amen.
Heavenly hope.
Yeah.
Divine hope.
Amen.
Okay? No, it's not earthly hope.
Come on.
Amen. We believe in something that's tangible. Whatever God promised, tangible. Even you don't see it, you know it's going to happen.
Amen.
And that's what the hope coming, you see.
Yes.
Faith and hope working together.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Godly hope is not an optimistic outlook or wishful thinking without any foundation. Then let me repeat it. Godly hope is not an optimistic outlook of wishful thinking without any foundation.
Come on.
But in the sense of confidence and expectation based on solid certainty.
Amen.
Godly hope rests in God's promises.
Come on.
You see? Amen. That's what we are hope, because we believe in God's promises. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Are you believing God's promises?
Amen.
That's your hope right there, okay? That's your godly hope. Because you believe that God is faithful. And whatever he promised, he will bring it to pass.
Come on.
So you have faith in the promise. When you receive the promise of God, you believe.
Yes.
And yes!
Absolutely.
Right? But then time passes and the promise haven't materialized. But your hope don't allow you to give up.
Come on.
And believe it.
Amen.
You see, that's what a godly hope is. I know God promised. And doesn't matter what you see.
Come on.
That godly hope, keep that faith present now.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The hope is linked with faith. They work together.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I see many people, they say, God promised this will not happen yet. But when they speak, I don't see the hope in there.
Yeah.
And they give up. And when persons give up, a lot of negative things happen in their life. The way they speak, the way they act. See, because they lost that godly hope. Amen?
Amen.
Faith is the present possession. Hope is confidence. Amen? Amen? Hallelujah. Hope is confidence. I know it's going to happen. Why you know it's going to happen? Because God promised it.
Amen.
Amen? Let's go to Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Amen?
Amen.
And now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Amen? You heard that?
Amen.
Hope for. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Okay? Hallelujah. Things hoped for.
Come on.
Okay. You don't see it, but you believe and you hope, keep you in believing.
Come on.
That's going to happen.
Yes.
You see, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Amen. You're not hoping for something that is not true. You're something for something, let me repeat it, something that God promised to you.
Yes.
Can be through His word or personal to you. That you hope is in that.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Then you got the evidence on that. Why? Because God's promise. And that hope keeps seeing it. Even in the natural, you don't see nothing. There's nothing that changed. But that hope keep your faith alive.
Amen. Come on.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Those people that we read here in Hebrews 11, we're not going to read the whole chapter, but you read the whole chapter, they put together faith and hope. Because we see here in Hebrews 11, that some of them do not receive the promise, but they believe because they have that hope.
Amen.
They had that godly hope.
Amen.
And they continue believing. Even they left this area without receiving the promise. Some of them. You see. Hope keep the faith alive.
Amen.
Look verse 2. It says, for by it the elders obtained a good testimony. Why? By faith and hope.
Yes.
The testimony was God promised I want to receive it. Yes. I will have it.
Yes.
I see it.
Come on.
That's what a good testimony. Okay? Because within the testimony is when you just received the promise. No, that testimony, even you haven't seen it, even it happened yet, you continue believing and you confess it.
Yes, hallelujah.
And that happened here in Hebrews. They were confessing, some of them that didn't receive the promise, they were confessing, they were so.
Amen.
Because they believed the one who promised God.
Amen.
And that hope keep their faith alive.
Hallelujah.
Godly hope. Amen?
Amen.
That's what the testimony. They have good testimony. That's what I'm reading about them here in Hebrews 11. Not only to those who received the promise, but those who did not receive the promise. But they believe.
Yes.
Because that godly hope.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Romans 8. Romans 8, we're going to read verse 20. Verse 20, Romans 8. For the creation was subject to futility, not willingly. Remember, why was subject to that? Because the sin of Adam, right? The creation, the whole creation. Willing, not willingly, but because of him was subjected in hope. Okay? You know, when Adam sinned, our father, Our Heavenly Father have a plan of redemption to Jesus Christ. Amen. And that was the hope for everything.
Yes.
What soldier and hope? What was the hope? The redemption in Jesus Christ. Just the whole creation, if we know, the Bible says the whole earth is going to be it's going to be redeemed. Everything is going to be redeemed in Christ. Okay? Everything. Amen? Because that was the hope. And we see the creation, they said the whole creation groaned. Okay? Because they want to see the revelation of the sons of God. That's all. Okay? Just, it's a hope. Okay? Hope. Amen? For the creation was subject to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected in hope. Okay? Because we know what was that hope from the beginning when Adam sinned. The hope was that God already had the plan of redemption or salvation through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That was a hope. Even the prophets spoke about it. You know, because God chose the prophet, there's going to be a redemption, there's going to be a salvation, there's going to be a restoration to Jesus Christ. They were prophesying. And that's what the hope they have, they have godly hope too.
Come on.
Even they didn't experience, but through faith, because they believe the word of God, they had that hope of the promise of God.
Amen.
And they was prophesying. All the prophets, we read the prophet. The prophet was talking about Jesus. Even David spoke about Jesus, my redeeming life. You see, that was a hope. That was a godly hope.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. That was a godly hope because he knew, because he heard the prophets. And David was a prophet too. And he was prophesying. Okay. Even Jesus came many years after David, he was prophesying, my redeeming life.
Hallelujah.
You see? Just when you have that godly hope, you don't see the things around you.
Amen.
Amen. That godly hope made you to look unto the future.
Come on.
Okay. Because something that God promised to us don't come to pass just right there in the moment. Something takes time. But if you don't have that godly hope, you lose your faith. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's important. The godly hope is important. Let's repeat verse 20, Romans 8. For the creation was subject to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected in hope. Amen. In hope. Okay. What did you hope? Do you have that godly hope?
Amen.
The way that God promised to you is going to come to pass.
Hallelujah.
But because you haven't seen it yet, you are depressed, losing your faith. Remember, God's faith.
Amen.
You just do your part.
That's right.
And keep doing it.
Hallelujah.
Because God will do his part.
Yes.
He will do it. But you have to do yours.
Amen.
The first part to us is belief. And missing with that hope. And obedience.
Amen.
Because God's going to do his part. Amen?
Amen.
As we're in Romans 8, let's jump to verse 24. We're going to read 24 and 25. Amen? Hallelujah. For we were saved in this hope. You see? We were saved in this hope. The hope of redemption. Amen? Hallelujah. But hope that is seeing is not hope. If you see it's not hope, why you want to hope for something you haven't seen? Right? Okay. For we were saved in this hope, but hope that seeing is not hope. For why does one still hope for what he sees?
Come on.
If I got something that I was waiting for, hoping for, and I got it, I don't need to have more hope because I got it.
Yeah.
Just we hope for something that we're waiting for. Just we were saying in this hope, what was the hope? Of hope of redemption. We were saved in that hope that God already proclaimed from the beginning. And the prophet was declared, okay? There is going to be a salvation through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. And we were saved in that hope.
Hallelujah.
We have our salvation. We have our redemption.
Yes.
Okay? But we'll continue our hope for all those things that God promised to us. Amen? We continue believing. Amen? We continue. I don't need to hope for salvation because I'm saved already.
That's right.
But I have to hope for the other things that God has promised to me.
Amen.
And only to me personally. Things that God has promised is going to do. Amen? And that happened. Yeah, it haven't happened yet. But I have faith and hope that those things are true because God has promised.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
And I'm not going to give up because I see the things that are going wrong in this world. Amen. That's going to change.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's my hope. Amen.
Amen.
Godly hope.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Verse 25 says, "By we hope for what we did not see, we eagerly, eagerly, we persevere." Remember the word the Lord said, persevere. We persevere. Amen.
Amen.
We eagerly wait for it. Okay, the word comes with perseverance.
Hallelujah.
You see? But we hope for what we do not see. We eagerly wait for it with perseverance.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Yes.
We eagerly wait with perseverance. We don't give up.
Amen.
Some people give up so soon. Are we not?
Come on.
I trust in my Lord. I trust in my Father.
Hallelujah.
He's faithful.
He is faithful.
Amen?
Amen.
He is faithful. Hallelujah. So as we see here, according to the scripture, the hope, that hope was our deliverance. Amen?
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ. Again, hope is confidence. Amen? That godly hope is confidence. Amen. You just important to perseverance. Okay? You know, that's you persevere. But you persevere in the things of God.
Amen.
Because things don't go our way, we're not gonna give up.
Amen.
We persevere and continue believing. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Some people get it was too soon. I see it. You can see in their faces. You can see in the meaning. You can see in the way they speak. They already lose hope, this godly hope. Because the hope they have is not godly hope. Romans 5. You know, we see the people, they went through things and comes out of those, whatever was ugly thing, you know, difficult things. And they ask, what made you believe that you're going to come out of that thing? He said, I have hope.
Amen.
Where's my hope?
Amen.
See, there was a godly hope. They didn't give up. Even with everyone could give up, they did not give up. Because the hope, that godly hope. Amen?
Amen.
Romans 5, verse 1. Said, therefore, having been justified. We in Romans 5. Therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Through whom also we have access by faith, see,
Amen.
By faith into this grace, and we will stand and rejoice and hope of the glory of God. Rejoice
yes.
and hope. We need that godly hope most in this time we're living.
Yes.
See. Everything looks like a upside down. Yeah. You heard all come the negative things. We need this godly hope.
Amen.
Amen. And you know, and he said, we stand and rejoice and hope of the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
You see?
Thank you, Father.
Amen. We have to have that godly hope that the glory of God will manifest in our life. Amen. Hallelujah. And rejoice. We need some rejoices, man. Verse 3 says, and not only that, but we also glory in tribulations. Only the hope made you glory in tribulation, faith and hope. Amen.
Amen.
Glory in tribulation. Knowing that tribulation produces perseverance. You see? Perseverance. And perseverance, character. And character, hope.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. While you going to think that's working in you too.
Come on.
It's working your character. It's working in your hope. Amen?
Amen.
He said, now hope does not disappoint. Hope, listen, hope does not disappoint. When everything is upside down, hope, keep you believing.
Amen.
Hope does not disappoint because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us.
Amen.
Amen. We see hope everywhere. Amen. Hallelujah. When Christian goes through hard time, hope is the anchor to hold on until receive deliverance of the promise.
Hallelujah.
The hope is your anchor.
That's right.
When you go through things, hope is your anchor.
Amen.
Until the deliverance come, or the answer to your prayer, or receive your promise.
Amen.
See, so hope is important, the godly hope. Amen. Hallelujah. How we have the godly hope? Through Jesus Christ, because we believe that everything is through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And because that, we have the hope. That godly hope. The thing is not going to continue the same we see it. Amen. The thing can change because Amen. God has promised. Amen. And we trust. And people ask, what is the evidence for you that God's going to do it? Because He promised faithful.
Amen.
And you know why you say that? Because that godly hope in you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
That hope. Because I see brother and sister, they say, I have faith for this, but when the thing is taking longer, I don't see their faith anymore. Why? Because they start questioning God. See, it's not hope. There's not godly hope is not there. And the faith disappear in them. Because it's not godly hope. Amen?
Amen.
Godly hope see the future blessings.
Come on.
Amen?
Amen.
See the future blessings. And will not be disappointed. Because the Holy Spirit gives evidence in our hearts that God loves us.
Amen.
And because God loves us, He's going to do what He says He's going to do.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
He will. You believe God. He will.
Amen.
That's a hope in you. You think, oh, my life's over. I'm not going to achieve what God said. Let that hope arise in you and believe God.
Yeah.
And believe God. Things can look dark, but you got the hope, you see light.
Amen.
Amen. You see light. You see light in the middle of darkness.
That's right.
You see blessed when other people see other things.
Come on.
Philippians chapter 1. I feel like some people that I know in my heart there, I feel right now that they lost hope. I feel that weight in my heart for them. It's not good. I really feel that. Say Philippians chapter 1.
Amen.
Yeah. Chapter 1, verse 20. Amen. According to my earnest expectation and hope. You see, and hope. You see, he now expects me. He got hope. You see? See that? According to my earnest expectation and hope, that in nothing I shall be ashamed, but with all boldness, as always, so now also Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. You see, this is the Apostle Paul. You know, thing we know Paul wasn't rosy all the time. He was persecuted, he was put in prison, you know, shipwrecked. Many negative things happen in the life of Paul. Okay? But look at his confession here. If we read what he was talking about in verse 19, let's go back to verse 19. Okay? In Philippians chapter 1, verse 19. For I know that this will turn out for my deliverance. He's in prison, remember. Through your prayer and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, according to my earnest expectation. You see? He's in prison, but he's expecting and he has hope.
Amen.
He said, but look what he said, that in nothing I shall be ashamed. Okay? Because he said, okay, I'm in prison for the gospel, but I'm not feel like down.
Come on.
I don't feel like I'm losing because I'm confined.
Come on.
He said, I don't want God told me to do it. I'm going to continue doing it here.
Amen.
And remember, when Paul was in prison, most of the guard got saved because of Paul. Any guard, they changed the guard, they sent another guard, and he got saved by Paul.
Come on.
Okay, I think he wasn't a change. I'm in prison, but I'm continue doing it.
Come on.
You don't stop doing what God told you to do because the thing got tough.
Come on.
Okay. And he said, and in nothing shall be ashamed, but with all boldness, as always. He said, as always. Always. It was the same. So now also, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. You see? He said, doesn't matter.
Come on.
They kill me, Christ will be magnified. Yeah, my life, he will be magnified.
Amen.
What he was saying, I will continue doing what I was called to do.
Yes.
And I'm not changing, I'm in prisons. And I'm not changing, I'm in life. Because I'm doing what God called me to do. And this is my earnest expectation. Yeah, I'm free, good. Yeah, I continue preaching good because we continue doing what He called me to do.
Hallelujah.
You see? But yeah, hope, yeah. Did you think this is a confession of someone who lost hope? No. The person that lost hope don't speak this way.
Come on.
That's a godly hope.
Yes.
Godly hope keep alive the promises.
Hallelujah.
It was alive in Paul, his confidence in God and Jesus because the godly hope.
Hallelujah.
And he said, Jesus will magnify me in their own life. You see, this godly hope.
Amen.
People that don't hope don't speak this way.
Amen.
They down. They don't see the light. They don't see the future. And when we see people like that, we have to pray for them because it's danger.
Amen.
When people lose hope.
Yes.
More if they are believers. For I know that this will turn out for my deliverance through your prayers and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ according to my earnest expectation and hope. And hope. That in nothing I shall be ashamed, but with all boldness, as always. So now also Christ will be manifest in my body, whether by life or by death. Don't lose your hope because you're in a tight situation.
That's right.
Continue believing in the Lord.
Amen.
Continue believing in the vision. Even you think it is that just doesn't look the way that God presented to you. Remember, He made way that there is no way. He may pull in the desert. When He do it.
Yes.
For He's God. He don't lie. When He said, it's so.
That's right.
And we said to you, and what is written is established in heaven.
Amen.
And because established in heaven, you got decreed it. Because it's true. But you have to have that godly hope. Amen.
Amen.
We don't walk by sight, we walk by faith.
Amen.
And God, hope keep alive the faith.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And Paul had godly hope.
Amen.
That way speak this way. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What Paul was saying is, I am confident. Confident who? In Christ. That's why his confidence, his boldness was in Christ. And not because he was super bold. His confidence was in Christ. They would say, I am confident on Him.
Yes.
That's why the hope, godly hope. When you trust in God, you don't trust in your circumstances. But you trust in God.
Hallelujah.
Who raised the dead.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay. I have the hope.
Amen.
I've been having it for a long time. Hallelujah. It's growing strong.
Hallelujah.
1 Corinthians 13. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 13. Hallelujah. See, and now abides faith, hope, you see? And now abides faith, hope, love. These three, but the greatest of these is love. Then we see hope between faith and love. You see, faith and love were, faith, love, hope were together. So they three were together.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, they work together. We have to have those three.
Amen.
Faith, hope, and love.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Working together. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Godly hope is needed in this side of eternity. We need that godly hope now. When we go to heaven, we don't need hope because everything is established already.
Amen.
Everything is done in the other side of eternity. But now, on this side of eternity, we wait for things to come to pass. And because of that, we have to have godly hope.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10. Turn to Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you there?
Amen.
Verse 23. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope. You see?
Amen.
Fast. Amen. Be persistent, right?
Amen.
Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering.
Hallelujah.
You see, even like faith, that we cannot waver in our faith, in our hope, we cannot waver in our hope.
Yeah.
We cannot say, oh yeah, I hope the gospel, and then see, the scripture said that let us hold fast our faith, right? But here, this scripture is telling us, let us hold fast the confession or hope. Just the same way we hold fast the confession of our faith, the same way we hold fast the confession of our hope. Do you see that?
Amen.
Do you see that? The same way. Amen. The same way you hold fast the confession of your faith. The same way you hold fast the confession of your hope.
Hallelujah.
Without wavering. For your promise is
faithful.
Hallelujah. Who your promise is
faithful.
Faithful. Hallelujah. That's what you hold fast. The confession of your hope. You don't wait. Amen? Because God is faithful.
Amen.
That's your hope right there. That's your godly hope right there. You don't waver. Doesn't matter. God is faithful. God is faithful.
Amen.
Amen? God is faithful. What are you waiting for? What are you hope? God is faithful.
Hallelujah.
What do you believe? Because God is faithful.
Amen.
And you don't wait. But look at this. No, God is faithful. People want to give you evidence on the fast the thing that you can see, the thing happening now. But your hope is in the truth of God's word.
Amen.
And you're not wavering. And people say, but look at this. He said, no, I believe God. He's faithful.
Amen.
But look at this. No, I believe God's faithful.
Hallelujah.
Do you see that?
Amen.
That's the life of the believers, man. We believe God is faithful.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
Believe that. Then don't wait. Amen? Be steadfast. Amen? Without wavering. And confess that you trust in God.
Hallelujah.
And His promise. Say, for your promise is
faithful.
Your promise is faithful. Why people believe somebody else when they promise something to them?
Come on.
And they like, maybe I'm not going to have it. You see, that person can have a problem, even they have a good heart to do the thing they say they're going to do to you. And they're limited for circumstances.
Yeah.
They can be limited for circumstances.
Yeah.
But not God.
Come on.
Amen?
Amen.
No circumstances can limit God to do what is His purpose in His heart to do for you. Amen. Believe. Let's read the scripture again. Hebrews 10, verse 23. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering. You see? Hold on. Remember, hold the anchor. And you hold the anchor.
Yeah.
Okay? Without wavering, for who promised faithful. God is faithful. God is faithful.
Amen.
Then you hold on.
Come on.
You have that hope. No way, baby. You got promise. You got that godly hope. They keep alive in faith.
Come on.
Looking at the future. The consummation of that promise. Amen? Alive. That's your evidence right there.
Amen.
What is your evidence? God promised.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
He promised.
Yes.
If somebody can, we are no evidence. Like, look at what happens in God promised.
Amen.
Amen? That's your godly hope right there. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Don't lose hope. Because God is faithful.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I know I'm here because that got you hope. I know that.
Amen.
Because God, my eyes are in Him. I'm trusting in Him. Third Peter, chapter 1. Verse 21. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're there.
Amen.
So, who through him believe in God. Through Jesus we believe in God. Amen.
Amen.
Who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, him glory to Jesus, so that your faith and hope are in God. You see, faith and hope together, right?
Amen.
Faith and hope and God. So we know through Jesus Christ, all the promise of God is yes and amen in Jesus Christ. So through Jesus Christ, we believe in God. Amen? And we know God, He did what He promised. He gave your Son to redeem us. He raised Jesus from the dead, right? And give glory to Him. To our faith, we trusting in God because Jesus Christ, right? Amen. Just every promise of God is just remain in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Okay? There our hope is in that. That whatever God promised is just in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because our trust in Christ make that possible. Amen. Hallelujah. There's our hope in Jesus. Our hope in God. Because God already said it through my Son Jesus. All the promise are just in Him.
Hallelujah.
So you know, you can say it's going to happen. Why you say that? Because through Jesus Christ, all the promise of God is just in Him. And that's my hope in Him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, faith and hope work together. Again. See, you see? Look at the last part of verse 21. It says, so that your faith, that your faith and hope are in God. Through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You don't say faith alone, say hope. Remember. Because something takes longer. So you have to have that hope.
Amen.
That godly hope.
Yes.
You know, because some people, they start, they say, ah, faith for this. But things don't come right away. So the faith this marriage.
Yeah.
You see? Because they haven't put that godly help in it.
Come on.
Just, that's what he said here. Faith and hope are in God.
Amen.
You see? Because he had the power to bring it to pass. Just when things don't come so quickly, like we love to come, you need a godly hope.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You need godly hope because the evidence around you are different than what you're expecting. So you need that godly hope right there. When your circumstances is telling you something else, you need your godly hope.
Amen.
To keep that faith alive.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Faith and hope working together. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Colossians. Colossians chapter 1. Amen, amen. Are you there? Read it together.
Amen.
Chapter 1, verse 27. Amen. To them, God will to make known, to them God will to make known what are the riches of the glory of the mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Hallelujah.
Okay, the hope of glory. You see, Christ in you, not outside you, no Christ in heaven, Christ in you, the hope of glory. Amen. Just what the hope of glory. Do you believe you have the hope? Remember what Paul said? The was an expectation and hope that Christ will magnify in his in life, just in death and him, just in death or life. Just he is telling us the Christ in hope, the Christ in us, in you, the hope of glory. That you have that hope. Do you have that hope that Christ will manifest in your life? Do you have that hope? Because here, when you have to have that hope like Paul. Paul has that hope. He has that hope that Christ will manifest in life. Death or life. Amen? Just here is telling all. It's clear. To them, God will to make known what are the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles. We qualify there, which is Christ in you. Christ in you, the hope of glory. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The glory of God manifests here in the earth. Amen. And that glory of God will manifest in the earth through believers. Do you have that hope?
Amen.
You see? You have that godly hope that Christ will manifest in your life here, not in heaven, here. Amen. How? What glory we're talking about? There is power. The everything that God is manifest through us here in this earth.
Yes.
To the people. Amen. But you have to have that hope. You see, one of the things of faith, faith. Always call you to action.
Amen.
Okay? Faith, true faith, real faith, always call you to action. Then we have that hope, this hope, the Christ in us, the hope of glory, we do something in our life. What that something is? To align ourselves with God's will.
Amen.
And because, you see, because we have that hope, the Christ in us, the hope of glory, amen, we align with God's will, those things happen. The glory of God will manifest in our life because you don't have that godly hope, you never align yourself with the will of God. You allow this world to swallow you up, and you go with the wind of this world, doing your own thing, and you never align with God's will. But you have this hope, you have this godly hope, the Christ in you, the hope of glory, you will align with the will of God.
Come on.
Because remember that God wanted to manifest his glory to the people. Say here Gentile, but we're calling out to the people of this world. Through us. Because Christ is in us. Amen. Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Amen.
The glory of God manifests through his sons and daughters. That when we have that godly hope, we align ourselves with the will of God.
Amen.
You don't have that hope. That godly hope, you never align with the will of God. Because what you say, oh, look at this world. Oh, things are so hard. Mm-hmm. Because you don't have no hope, you don't give your life to God's will.
Amen.
Only the godly hope make the believer separate from the things of this world.
Amen.
Why some believers, they are separated from the things of this world? You know why? Because they don't have this godly hope.
Amen.
Or they have an exercise. Because they don't believe the Christ in them, the hope of glory. They say, I will live my life the way I want to. And they don't even repent. And they make mistakes. Well, I hope so. God loves me. Yeah, he loves you. But you know what? He wants to manifest glory to you, through you,
amen,
and you, and through you. Amen? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. They have that hope, or have this hope, that Christ manifests himself in you and through you. Have this hope, this godly hope. Because that's the will of God. It's the will of God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 29. This scripture is important for me. Very important. Because it was a rhema word in the moment that I needed it the most. And I still holding up that speech.
Hallelujah.
I want to tell all these stories, but today, but I think I've told this story many times and I preach about that. Just telling you, Jeremiah 39, verse 11. Thank you, Jesus. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, say the Lord. Who said it?
The Lord.
Okay. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you a future and a hope. You see that? A future and a hope. Hallelujah. This is the thought of God for you. Remember? And I remember when I received this scripture. The way I received it was, you know, I know what from God. And I was needed to hear from him. And that's what he said. Man, and I've been holding on to this scripture. Let's repeat it. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the thoughts that I think. You see, God's thinking about you. God was thinking about me.
Hallelujah.
He always think good thing about us.
Okay?
God is not negative. You know, don't think that God was thinking about you, wrong thing about you. He doesn't do that. He always thinking good thing about us. He loves us. He's a good father.
Yes.
Amen. He's a good father. He loves us. God always thinking good about you.
Yes.
Okay? He said, for I know the thought that I think towards you. Talking like a loving father. He's a loving father. That's why he's talking here. He's speaking here. Like loving father. Speaking like loving father. Like loving father talking to his sons and daughters. Amen? For I know the thought that I think towards you, said the Lord. I remember the day I received this creation. I remember where I was, and I remember what I wanted to go do that day. Okay? For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, say the Lord, thoughts of peace, and not of evil. You see? God don't think evil about us. Amen? He's our Father. He's a good Father. Remember that God is a good Father.
Amen.
To give you a future, you see, remember hope, keep alive, look into the future. You know, hope don't look at the future all ugly.
Come on.
Hope don't look like there's no future. Hope don't look like it don't see like, oh, there's no way out. Hope don't say it's over. Hope don't say at the end. Jeremiah 3:9-11. Put it in your heart. Put this scripture in your heart. The same way it been rima word from me like 19 years. 19 years, exactly. Let it be a rima word for you too from this day forward. Thinking about our Father God. Okay, think that's the way he think about you. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you a future and a hope. You see that? And hope. What a hope does. He believes what God promised. God promised peace. God promised good future. You see? The hope keeps alive those promises of God for you. Amen? Godly hope. I know you really want to continue the verse below. But you have to do those things that's in the verse below.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know. And I'm not going to read it, but you can read it. But that's what I said, why this portion God gave me. Was a rhema word for me. And I hold on to that. Amen? This is one of the scriptures that have been my anchor for missing the Lord coming to the ministry. That was when the Lord coming to the ministry was at the time when he gave me that speech. 19 years. That be my anchor, one of the scriptures that be my anchor for my life. Because I believe what God said.
Amen.
So it doesn't matter what's going through in any time in my life, I believe they have a good future for me.
Amen.
I believe that the thoughts of my Father, my Heavenly Father, are good for me, no evil. I believe that He promised peace for me. I believe. I don't believe my circumstances, I believe what He said.
Yes.
See, that's godly hope. Amen?
Amen?
That's godly hope. Hallelujah. Believe that our Heavenly Father wants good things for you. And He has planned for your life. Good plans. Good future. Believe that.
Amen.
See, let godly hope arrives in your heart to see God holding you, taking you forward. Remember, He thinks good about you, God, our Heavenly Father. When you think about God, don't think that God is thinking something wrong about you. Don't think that God thinks something wrong about you. He's thinking about good thoughts. He said good thoughts about you. That's what he has for you. Because he has a plan. It's really written in heaven. Your future. But you have to align with his will too.
Amen.
And you have to believe him. But God don't sit in heaven thinking to hurt us. Remember, he already blessed us with all heavenly blessing.
Hallelujah.
Just good things.
Amen.
From our Father. Have that godly hope. Amen.